Hi, let's talk about Waldeyer's ring. In this video, we'll discuss the relationship of Waldeyer's ring to the pharynx. So Waldeyer's tonsillar ring is a collection of mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue that's found in the pharynx. These discrete clumps of malt, as they're called, are referred to as tonsils, and they represent a way for your body to deal with any pathogens that are taken in through the aerodigestive pathway. So anything inhaled through the nasal cavity or anything inhaled or consumed through the oral cavity has to eventually bump up against mucosa that is hosting this malt tissue. These tonsils are sites of immune response. So pathogens are brought into contact with antigen-presenting cells, such as macrophages and dendritic cells, also lymphocytes, T cells, B cells, so as to raise an immune response. Now, the several tonsils that are located throughout the pharynx are the pharyngeal tonsil at the roof of the nasopharynx. The pharyngeal tonsil is oftentimes referred to as the adenoid. The adenoid is probably at its greatest size about 5 years of age, and it tends to involute or get smaller and acquiesce into the wall of the nasopharynx during late adolescence. This tonsil can be quite large in young children, so it can be implicated in obstructive sleep apnea events and may opt to remove it to help resolve that sleep apnea. Just posterior to the opening of the auditory tube, we have the tubal tonsils. These tubal tonsils are very small, discrete clumps of malt tissue that deal with materials as they may enter into the auditory tube. Now, within the oropharynx, there's a set of palatine tonsils that sit within the tonsillar fossae of the fauces. The fauces is the region of the oropharynx called the throat. These palatine tonsils can sometimes be quite large, and they can even project out into the oropharynx. When they become inflamed or during tonsillitis, they can be quite painful to any materials that pass over them, and they can even occlude part of the airway. The palatine tonsils are the tonsils that people refer to as the tonsils, and they're the targets of tonsillectomy. These palatine tonsils tend to involute after puberty. Finally, on the root of the tongue, we have the lingual tonsil. The lingual tonsil is quite large and is what is coming into contact with any foodstuffs that pass over the dorsal surface of the tongue. If you notice, these tonsils comprise a ring, with the nasopharynx being the superior portion of the ring and the oropharynx being the inferior portion of the ring. The ring is bisected by the soft palate. So altogether, we have what is known as Waldeyer's tonsillar ring. So we've discussed the several types of tonsils: pharyngeal, tubal, palatine, and lingual. This is your summary slide. Thank you very much for your time.